So here we go, ready to kick off the 2013 college football season here in NCAA Football 14 Road to Glory. And the Missouri Tigers are getting ready to go against their first opponent of the season, the FCS East. I believe the Rampagers or something like that. I forgot already. But we have to go check out our practice mode to see, you know, what our team's looking like, what I can do, what my receivers can do, what my running back can do. And we're going against, you know, the practice defense. They run a base 4-3 on the other team. So we're just going up against a regular 4-3, which is pretty good for me. And I'll drive back here, throw the ball deep to Bell on the slant route to pick up a first down, pretty much. There's no first down markers in practice. It's either a touchdown or you get yardage. But one thing that you're going to notice here in the practice mode is that, well, one, they have a nice little indoor practice facility. So if you want to go indoor, you can use the indoor practice facility or you can use the outdoor one. Or you can use the one for the Nike skill training, which I actually don't really like that much. But, I mean, that's one thing you're going to notice. And then another thing is the fact that the plays that the practice mode runs, starting out, maybe the first three or four plays are exactly the same. And then it starts grouping plays out of different formations. And it's, like, really weird that, you know, it does this. But, you know, here we go, 14 reps in or 14 reps remaining. And I'm cutting left and I break a tackle and I almost busted that one off. But the defender trailing behind got me. But hey, it's practice. You're not trying to score every play. I mean, the goal, you want to score every play. Get that coach trust up so that you can progress as fast as possible. But, I mean, we're having a lot of fun here. There we go, extending the play, hitting Thornton. And we'll drop back the pass. This is probably my favorite play of the practice, throwing this one deep to Doyle, and he's going to catch it. Break two tackles. Man, he's in the end zone for, I guess, 6 points in the practice. But, I mean, check this play out. He runs around. Then he's coming up the field, and I throw this ball right where it needs to be. He breaks 17 and 21's tackle pretty much at the same time, and he's just in the end zone for a touchdown. I mean, that's going to be all season, and I'm really excited to see what he can do once we start going up against some more tough opponents. There we go to Harrison on the out route. He'll pick up some nice yardage there, and we're doing a pretty decent job in this practice, throwing it deep to Thornton on the corner route. And he picks up a first down, I guess. I'm already in commentary mode for the game that's coming up. And there we go, throwing an interception at the end of the practice. So it wasn't perfect, but, you know, we got some good XP, 3,468 to work with. And we'll save that for the next week because you guys saw in the decision video that I used pretty much everything that was useful in terms of skill upgrades. So here we go, first game of the season. And we're going against FCS East. And obviously, this is the best game to see what your incoming freshman starting quarterback can do. And check out the fact, I mean, this is what I was talking about in the decision video as well. There's no intro for Road to Glory. They took the intro completely out. Where is the pageantry for Road to Glory? Where is the intro? I mean, everything else. Even if I have to listen to that country music every single game, I mean, I'd rather do that than just have this black screen fade into the actual field and then have the coin toss. I mean, that's just ridiculous. But here we go, first and 10, first play of the game, dropping back, almost going down there on the first play, but I end up breaking off a huge run there, getting that ball past midfield, and I pick up 17 yards on the first play of my collegiate career, and that was a pretty good way to start it out. I don't know why the camera glitched the way it did, but it did, and I'm not really upset with that. I actually like that camera angle. It was nice and wide, and it actually worked out. So here we go on first and 10. Trying to pick up another first down. Dropping back. Thought about throwing it deep to Bell. Just going to dump it off to Thornton here, and he picks up a first down. So 21 yards on the next play of the game. So far, 38 yards here on offense, and we have not slowed down. Here we go on second and 10. Dropping back. Looking for a receiver. No one's going to be open on the curls. Taking off the run, and for some reason, Thornton doesn't block the corner, and I have to duck it back inside. And unfortunately, I couldn't pick up the touchdown there, but I have 32 yards rushing so far in the game. And so far in the game, FCS East has done nothing to stop us. Here we go on first and goal. Thought about running this one up the middle of the field. Going to bounce it out to my left, trying to extend the play. There goes Bell, and Bell's got that one in the end zone. We pick up a touchdown, and we are officially on the board here. Nice, not even a nice, a perfect way to start out the season. You know, first possession goes for a touchdown. Nice little mix of running past. The freshman quarterback's doing his thing here. Dropping back here on a play action screen. And I absolutely hate this play because if it's in man coverage, you guys saw that the receiver really didn't do a very good job of bouncing it out wide. And the corner probably could have picked that one off. Here we go on the wide receiver option. And I keep this one for myself. Picking up a first down. and I probably could have pitched that play, but I decided to just tuck it and pick up a first down, play it safe. Here we go, second and five, taking this one, running to my left, and I'm looking for a block down the field, but Thornton, for some reason, can't give me another block that I needed. Should have just gone up the field instead of coming back towards me, but hey, it's another first down, not really going to complain about it. Here we go, first and 10, a minute left here in the first quarter, dropping back, play action, inverted veer, and we pick up a first down to Thornton. Here we go, second and 10, running the first read option of the game, going to hand this one off to Dunbar, because the defensive end sat on that play, and he picks up 10 yards, and we are faced with a third and inches, and here comes the next play of the game, third and inches, read option again, keeping this one for myself. And I thought my offensive linemen were going to do a better job of blocking going down the field, but they really didn't. So here comes first and 10, dropping back. That's going to be Doyle on the slant, and he's in the end zone for a touchdown. That's two touchdowns here in the first quarter. And there is still a lot of time left in this game if we don't just completely blow out the other team. Hopefully we can stay on during the fourth quarter. But here comes first and 10, triple option, keeping it for myself, making the right decision. And I pick up 12 yards. I could have busted that off for an even bigger game, but I'm too slow, not fast enough to get away from the linebacker who was in pursuit. Second and four, upcoming inverted veer, keeping this one for myself again. Cutting left, cutting right, cutting back to my left, and sometimes this game makes your cuts a little too harsh. All I was trying to do is just follow my offensive lineman up the field, but as you can see here, did a pretty nice job of weaving in and out. My offensive lineman, once again, could have blocked a little better, and there I go getting hype. I don't even care about the lack of blocking. We pick up a first down, and here comes a third one hand. This one off to Dunbar outside, and he's going to get stood up by number 20 of the other team, and we end up losing 2 yards, and for some reason we can't tack on a field goal, so we have to come out here in the next possession. Second and 8, going outside to Doyle in the out route, and he picks up 16 yards on that play, pick up a first down, and we're looking to go no huddle here, running the same play. And I'm looking to take a shot down the field here with my outside receivers because FCS East is playing terrible defense passing. And here we go on first and 10, dropping back, launching it deep for Thornton. And he comes down with it, 29-yard reception. Couldn't stay on his feet, but he makes a nice job of dragging the toes. And here comes a first and goal, read option once again. The defensive end crashes, and I'm taking this one. Oh, I take it a little bit too far to the right, but I end up taking it inside the end zone for a touchdown. And I've got myself 3 touchdowns here in the first half, and we come back on the field with 47 seconds left in the second quarter, looking to put up some more points. Coach is like, you know what, let's just kill it, running verticals here, and for some reason, I don't see Bell down the field. I thought that, you know, Doyle was going to be the only one open on that play. I focused too much on him, and I totally missed out on hitting Bell, but here goes Bell on the next play of the game, and he gets the first down, moving the ball down the field, 6 seconds left here in the half. And we'll come out here and try to kick a field goal for some reason, but we end up missing a 63-yard field goal for some reason. I don't even know why we did that, but here we go, throwing a Bell on the first play of the next quarter, 43-yard reception for him, and this game is getting out of hand. I am looking really good right now. I'm looking like a veteran starter here on the field, and that's why I was the number one recruit in the nation. I was doing things on offense in high school. I'm still doing it here in college so far. And there we go, picking up another first down. Second and goal upcoming. Hand off inside to Dunbar. Dunbar is going to take this one and just tuck it into the end zone and give us a nice little 30-0 lead here in the third quarter. We get the ball back here literally 30 seconds later, and we'll drop back to pass. Going to roll to our right, and I'm going to just take this one up the field, and I probably should have just slid there to avoid taking a big hit because you guys know how fumble-prone I am, but I've almost got 100 yards rushing here in this game. And this is just getting outstanding. Here we go to Doyle. And look at this move that Doyle puts on the defenders. He makes 2 defenders miss. He turns what was maybe a 4 or 5 yard gain into a 30 yard gain. And that is absolutely ridiculous. Third and goal here for the Missouri Tigers. Dropping back, throwing this one inside. And that one's going to get intercepted. And I honestly could not believe this happened. But as you guys are going to see on the instant replay in a second, this was not necessarily a bad play, but it was a really well, I guess, disguised man coverage. You know, number 14, I guess, was a man coverage on Alvarez, and he cut all the way over the field and ended up picking me off. So I make a mistake there, first interception of the season, and I'm trying to score here on 3rd and 13, but I throw that ball too late. I should have thrown it before Thornton made that cut to the outside. He would have been down the field for a touchdown. But, you know, we got to do what we got to do. Here comes Dunbar breaking 2 tackles so far. That's going to be a third. And he's taking that one down the field for a 17-yard rush. And Dunbar is doing a pretty good job of facilitating on the run game here against this team. And there we go. inside. I mean, come on. Once again, the slants have just been open all game, and FCS East just cannot stop these receivers. This is the main reason why I came here to Missouri, is because these receivers are beasts. And here I go on second and 11 using my receivers for blocks, and I'm trying to get this one into the end zone, and there's no way that I didn't score a touchdown there. Check out the instant replay, but I do have 109 yards rushing in the game so far. But check out the instant replay. I'm literally going to sit on the goal line. There's no way I wasn't in the end zone. But we'll just come out here on first and goal, trying to just run this one inside for Dunbar to give him two touchdowns here in the game. And that's exactly what he's going to do. I would have loved to have that rushing touchdown, but hey, we always got another game to do it. And we end up wrapping up this win against the way underpowered FCS East team. And play of the game is going to be this inside pass that went to Doyle here on the slant. That was the second touchdown of the game. And we come out here, we did what we were supposed to do. We came out here and got the win. Obviously, there was no way we were going to lose to this team, even with the, you know, limited success that Mizzou had last year. They weren't going to bounce back or come back this season and just, you know, do the same thing all over again. But, you know, we come out here, get the win. Nice little 45-0 win over this way weaker team. But, you know, we do have Toledo coming up in the next week. That should be a little more challenging for this team. Honestly, this should have been play of the game. I mean, if I could choose play of the game, this definitely would have been it. You know, extending the play and hitting Bell in the end zone for a touchdown. I feel like that was a play of the game. But, you know, we'll always have more opportunities to make better highlights. And there we go. Nice little stat line there. Over 400 yards total offense and three touchdowns. And unfortunately, that one interception. But, you know, things happen. It's not like we had a terrible game. You know, we did a pretty good job, over 100 yards rushing, over 300 yards passing. And obviously, we're going to head into the next week of the season. That'll be week number 2 against the Toledo Rockets. And I actually have a friend that plays for Toledo, but I don't know if he's actually in this game. I'm going to have to go check out the official rosters and see where he's at. But here we go, week number 2. That'll be in the next episode. I want to thank you guys for watching this one. And, you know, obviously, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.